Yep, it's about that time. Everybody, it is so about that time. Tuesday night live stream, Emceemur coming at you on our regular time. I am joined by my main man right here, Triple J, J-Town James Jonan, and we are bringing you day one footage of Fallen Legion, Rise to Glory on the Switch. This one's been on the radar for a long time. I mean, since I heard that they were going to announce it, I said this is exactly the kind of thing that I would want to play on the Switch, and we're going to. We should be joined by Chris from NIS America at some point during this live stream tonight for some live Q&A, which will also be excellent. Urge you all to participate in that. You ready to get down on this thing?
I'm ready to see what's
up. Oh, man. We're joined by Retro Heck. Welcome, Heck, to our Tuesday night live stream of Fallen Legion on the Nintendo Switch. Select character, you know who we're going with.
You got it.
Captivating she is. A fearless princess who protects her people by fighting on the front lines receives a talking grimoire as her father's final gift. I think we're going to play as her.
That's where I would go to.
Yeah.
You don't pass up the tiny redhead. You just don't.
Well, so something...
Ooh, this is pretty.
Isn't it? And something I think a lot of people that have reviewed this might be missing is that this has some overtones of Grand Kingdom on NIS. Mm-hmm. It seems to be cut from the same cloth when looking at the way the combat is laid out. And I may not be 100 on that, but we're going to see how close we are. Also, another fantastic game. A game that I brought to you day one. A game that I did an unboxing of the Collector's Edition on. A game that has even gone free to play on PSN at one point. If you missed out on that, I'm sorry. But that, man.
Yeah, I think it was a couple months ago.
Well, it had a great thing going. What it had that this one doesn't have, not that this needs it, because this has its own thing and is obviously very story-driven, but Grand Kingdom had that my-off option, or a semi-my-off, you know, where you could create, you know, your different units, but you could name them, customize them, give them different colors and whatnot. Mm-hmm. We're joined by Mr. Venegas Games and Toys, the Lucky Collector, and Gen X Grown-Up. Always remember, if you are not a Gen X Grown-Up, you could be a Gen X Grown-Up. Welcome, guys, to Tuesday night live stream. Her country was dying.
It had been an open secret amongst the princes that our economy had been in slow decline for the last decade. The consequence of building an empire on conquest and then conquering everything.
Fight and flight. The serpent.
So is this a turn-based or a real time?
Yes, supposedly it is. But it almost seems like it takes on some of the dynamic that Has Been Heroes does. If like lane the combat. So again, it's not exactly like Grand Kingdom, but the fact that we have lanes and, you know.
Yeah, I can definitely
see where I'm going with that.
I see the comparison here.
We have action points. Let's do it. We're rocking off! We're ripping a boot! Uh oh, we have some venom going on.
I'm trying to figure out what the combat style is.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm just letting them have it, and they're doing it to it. And I know that's not going to cut it, just a little further in here. I'm trying to gauge what kind of cooldown we're looking at or what's up. We're joined by the Exo, and we're joined by Roaming Dan. Welcome, guys, to our Tuesday night live stream of Fallen Legion Rise of War on the Nintendo Switch. He seems rather serious. The book talks. With the Necronomicon. Got a face on it. Rex Warden has joined us. Welcome to the stream. Alright, so Chick's got the book out.
Do you use her in combat? It seems like you're just using the other guy. Oh, she can't.
Just let her turn loose. She'd be like my special. I see what's going on in the circle there. It's like a three-tiered thing, so you start cooling down once you've used all three of the hits. They're getting like three attacks per round. The animation's really cool.
Gorgeous.
Yeah. Press X to cast Cassandra's Coil. That's what I do in the toilet in the morning. And blast your foes with Princess Cecile's magic. It will cover a little bit of mana each time an exemplar attacks an enemy.
Genex Gromit says, Murr, can you sense the disturbance? I'm back in Atlanta this week.
Wow, are you in Atlanta this week? Are you staying straight through to the expo, or is this just a temporary stopover? And are you on your way over with a pizza? Would be my next follow-up question. You can switch spells by holding and pressing heals all exemplars with Alicia's Blessing.
Rex says, seems similar to some vanillaware games. Absolutely. I was thinking the same thing. I just finished up Dragon's Crown. Especially the art style. Very overtones of Dragon's Crown, Grim Grimoire, and Odin's Sphere.
Now, you know, I had a copy of Grim Grimoire not too long ago, and it was really...
You don't see that every day.
It was in such bad shape. I mean, I had to get rid of it, because I knew, you know, if I wanted that, I'd have to have a better-looking copy than that. I paid 50 cents for a disc-only copy, and it was in a bunch of smelly old burned DVDs and some shoebox that some guy had. All right, it wants me to revive here. I thought I was hitting it. So he's back. And now he's back. Alright, just here through Thursday. Alright, gotcha, John. Well, looking forward to SFGE. Emceemur will be live at that with Captain Retro. We will be doing a retro gaming channel there. Really looking forward to that. Southern Fried Gaming Expo, that's going to be exciting. Uncle Strange has joined us. Welcome, Unc. Always glad to have you in the stream. Tuesday Night Live. Fallen Legion on the Nintendo Switch. Margrave looks like he or she might mean business. The Legatus honored me with a Burnish Relic. And after I use it, your spirits will be useless. Oh, GXG will be in the Friday podcast. Nice. That's going to be fantastic. They'd be missing out if they didn't. Because there ain't no podcast like a GXG podcast. I can tell you this from experience. This twitchy fool is right, you know. Your exemplars won't be able to scratch him. Wonderful, she says. I should remind you, if I perish here, you will end up in a fireplace eating a peasant's dinner. I mean, that depends on what are we eating for dinner. Oak City gamers are here, Mr. B says. Oak City,
welcome. I didn't see that either.
Oh, there we are. Go. Welcome, Oak City. Alright, so press and hold L, let's do that, to make all the exemplars block enemy attacks. But we don't recover AP while blocking, so that's the problem. So I see this is there's a lot of instances here where you're going to feel like you're button mashing, but there really is strategy here. And you know, as the further you get on, the more difficult this gets, the more that's going to be necessary.
I felt that same way in Dragon's Crown, which you were playing a couple weeks ago.
Played a little bit,
yeah. You know, at first glance, it seems like you hit the same button over and over with different directions, but it really, really does. There's an art to it.
What a bit about? Oh. I messed the first guy up.
There we go.
Oh, dude. Yeah.
You can't just hold it. You gotta...
Yeah, I had to throw it up there and then make sure I was getting enough of my turn back to take a shot on him, so... Not bad. You know, and I've heard people say that this is not an incredibly long game.
Yeah.
I'm not upset about that if it is, because you have two characters here, obviously, that you would want to do multiple playthroughs with, and that's not so invasive for me. Not every RPG has to be 200 daggum hours.
Oh, I
you
totally
know what
agree.
I mean? So it makes it more approachable, and overall, if you have a great game at the core, at its system, at its whole overall function, that is what's next to God.
The age of the ever-growing backlog is, we could use more short, good games.
I'm telling you. SGGs. The Squire. Octavia, please. You have to stop. Nothing would give me greater pleasure.
Take her as a playable character. Would that happen? removes that option.
That might be if we do a certain thing in a certain place. Greeting us as people inside the internet machine is the honorable and venerable CM Retro Gaming. Welcome, CM, to Tuesday Night Live Stream. We are playing Fallen Legion on the Nintendo Switch. Rise to glory! Cannot be blamed for the zeal of his soldiers. And I should mention again that Chris from NIS America should be joining us this evening for some Q&A on this game. So hopefully they'll be joining us later and you can fire off some questions to them about this and any other upcoming NIS titles.
Well, Captain's in the house and he says no notification that you were live.
Yeah, but Captain doesn't get notifications, and certain people have those problems from certain channels. It's an internal YouTube bug.
You don't say. YouTube bug.
One of what many. And it's not a bug we can stomp on, unfortunately. I get his, but he doesn't get mine. But there's other people's that I don't get, and they get mine. And there's no formula for it. All of my exemplars have been healed. These are the, again, let's go back, circling back, these are the kind of games that you want on your Nintendo Switch.
Yeah.
Now, I understand that Fallen Legion was playable on, I mean, there was a limited run game that came out of it, and I believe digitally that was an option on PS4, maybe earlier than that, but...
Possibly Vita, I feel like.
Yeah, definitely. I would be shocked if it wasn't. But, man, to have something like this portable... And, again, we talked about... I don't do as much portable gaming as I thought I would. But if it's going to be something, it's going to be something like this.
I do, but it's at home.
Yeah. One room, the other room, the toilet. Yeah. Wherever it goes. Am I paralyzed right now? Is that a thing? I love that she says what she's doing like it's Pokemon. Or Sailor Moon.
Street Fighter.
Moon Tiara Magic! You get a turn on Shuju.
I feel like she's joining you at the end of this. I don't know why. Got a feeling.
Yeah? Rex says, why not revive your other escort? That's probably a pretty good idea, Rex. That's the rough thing about streaming some of these things day one, and I'm not allowed to complain because it's a burden that I take on my shoulders, but...
NIS America in the house.
Oh, NIS America has joined us. Welcome. But you don't always get all of the controls right away the first time because we're talking, we're looking, we're chugging, but, you know...
You play an hour or two before stream, but that's
but I like you to gauge my reaction. Guys, we have NIS America in the house. Couldn't be happier about that for some live Q&A tonight. Again, if there's any questions you have about this or any upcoming NIS titles, I'm sure they would be pleased to answer. Just make sure you address your messages at NIS America so they know you're talking to them. Again, thanks so much for coming out, guys. So honored to have you in the house, as I and you as well are huge NIS fans. To answer your question, Gen X, this is my main man, Triple J, J-Town Justin. Playing some live Fallen Legion on the Nintendo Switch. Triple J is one of my go-to guys on RPGs. Not that I don't know what I like in RPGs, but if I ever even have half a question, I know if Triple J likes it, then it's my kind of game.
I can be picky. Play a lot of it.
Now we're going to see if I can do better this time. I got to remember how to revive these dudes.
Yes, that's true. Retro says I'm part of the D&D group. Yeah, you may have seen me in that video recently.
Yep.
We'll definitely be seeing more of that in the future.
Level 8 human fighter, if you're wondering.
Yep, Retro says rhymes of Odin Sphere. We mentioned that a little bit earlier in the Nowhere games.
The artwork is just gorgeous.
Is bar.
And the animation, it's just fantastic. These are the games right here, man. These are the ones that... You look up and the sun's coming up. You didn't get off of it and you were on it all day and night.
Yeah, NIS says up next to revive. very useful.
That's, yeah, I know it told me that, but at the moment I needed. And see, that's what's cool about this too. You know I'm big into turn-based games. And we see more and more RPGs getting away from turn-based. This kind of meets you halfway. I mean, I don't really have time to sit back and drink a cup of coffee and just take a relaxed approach to it. It is obviously time sensitive in places.
Yeah.
But it's a turn-based enough to where the strategy still comes into play. You know. And it still takes on that shape. So here we go.
City says found a copy of Odin's Sphere for 70 cents.
Oh wow!
That's, yeah.
And down an X is your recovery spell. Thank God NIS showed up.
It pops up, but it's so hectic.
It does, but we got so much going on here. It's hard to catch everything it's saying. But I mean, from what I could tell of what it was saying, it does a perfect job of explaining what you need to do. And you don't want it to be too easy either. Again, this is a game that you already know you're going to have multiple playthroughs of because you have two different characters. They each have their own meter, so you can use them when they're full. Good to know. So here's this thing again. And again, eating a peasant's dinner, that's not, I mean, it depends on what's for dinner. It may not be the worst thing ever. So we gotta get ready to block that thing. But each! Sweet. Deflect 50 attacks with perfect block. So there's achievements here. Roaming Dan says, can't wait for Disgaea remastered on PS4. Fantastic point, Roaming Dan. I am very interested in receiving a collector's edition of that. We've also got a collector's edition coming of the New Harvest Moon, which is also going to be fantastic. Another great addition to the Switch library here from NIS. Octavia, please, you have to stop. Robert Mitchell has joined us. Welcome, Robert. And yes, this does look cooler than the other side of the pillow, proverbially speaking. Yeah, as soon as I saw this, it was kind of like, done. And I'm scouring Amazon just because sometimes they get stuff listed up earlier than other retailers. Not that I don't look at NIS's site, too, because where their games are concerned, you definitely want to do that to make sure you're getting the collector's edition dibs on that specifically. But, yeah, always looking for games like this and then specifically interested in them on a console that you can take on the road.
Yeah, this would be a great on-the-road game.
Family vacation time, you can bet. Whatever they're doing, I'm doing this while they do whatever. Cassandra's coil! Okay, I think whatever she did there, we've got unlimited shots here for a minute. Everything went blue there for a second. You're getting coiled.
A 40-year-old gamer says the only place games like this are the Final Fantasy series. At one point, you could say that, but these days there's just so many good ones. You're missing out.
Yeah, and you know,
there's a lot of good RPGs and turn-based RPGs out there these days.
Little healing action. Thank you, NIS, for the tip. Yeah, and you know, I love that stuff as much as the next guy. I really enjoyed the Bravely Default, Bravely Second series, as did you in the Final Fantasy lineage. Yeah. You know, so in the same universe or whatever.
Radiant but story, it was so.
Still haven't even got a chance to start it. Yeah, you know.
Get a chance on it, man.
It's sitting right over there.
Yep.
It's on the list. What are you waiting for? Killer! She's betrayed you. Sparing her will gain us nothing. And may cost us everything. I have known Antoinette for years. There must be a reason. She needs to do a charisma check. Captain says, is this on the PS4? Yes.
Rather, it's available on the PS4, but you're playing it on the Switch today.
Yes, this would be the Nintendo Switch.
PS4 and I believe the Vita have it as well.
Yeah. Limited Run did a physical sale on it. Gaming Review Clan has joined us. Welcome, GRC. Is this on Steam? I'd be shocked if it wasn't. Now, I'm not an expert on all things PC, but... NIS America says, it is, but you didn't hear that from me.
The grimoire was right.
We're slowly getting into some PC gaming here, but my PC is basically our workhorse. It exists so that we can bring you things like this, but not much beyond
probably
that.
Probably couldn't pull double duty.
Yeah, we're console gamers by nature. I got an A on that. I don't know how proud I need to be of that. Some of that needs to be, some of that pride should beam off of NIS there. I didn't know what I was doing first off. We're joined by cool as Robert Payne. You know that it's not a live stream until CARP is up in the house. Welcome, Robert Payne. Glad to have you tonight on Tuesday Night Live Streams. A two-faced god of trickery and the cruelty of the Venumian face. Oh, I was going to go all out on that. This game is an autosave feature, thank God. Please do not reset or turn off the Nintendo Switch system when you see this icon. Welcome to Venumia. You can move the princess around the world. X to open the menu. I can't wait. Now, whenever I see maps like this and we do the dot to dot, I go right back to Final Fantasy Tactics.
Yeah,
I know that's not what we're doing
here,
but...
same thing. Yeah,
that and some, kind of the way that almost looks hand-drawn, it's really pretty.
Brings back good memories.
I'm saying.
Taking the map.
A two-faced god of trickery and cruelty, the Venumian face considered bad luck to even say Devon's name. Let's just say you might have accidentally summoned Devon this way. Male version of Devon, some that do evil and the parents that do collect on their... The female version schemes in the dark. Oh, okay.
As the princes saw the end coming, they turned on one another, consolidating their holdings.
Rebel Gaming Club has joined us. Welcome, Rebel Gaming Club. RGC, a lot of three-letter acronyms go on here. And it does look great so far, guys. I am so glad that this is here. I've been counting this down since it went up for pre-order, and I pre-ordered it the minute I saw it.
2 weeks later.
But that's not uncommon for me. And
sometimes that's what you gotta do, unfortunately.
Well, especially on the collector's
editions. Might not get this game unless you get...
And that's a good point. Guys, and we've talked about this on the Captain Retro podcast before... Pre-order your games. Don't get into that whole culture of, oh, I don't pre-order. Why not? Then you don't get the game. Because games like this, they got to know that you want it. And they're putting them out there. They want your support. That's not, don't worry about where you're getting it or how that you're supporting the publisher. And that's what's important. We want these games. I'm an NIS fan. I pre-order their games. I want to know this is their day one. I don't want to be the guy that ain't playing this. And then they're the guy that shows up. Oh, what do you mean it's sold out?
Why'd you come try to pick it up on day one?
Yeah, I mean, they're not going to ship 18 crates of them just because, just in case you might want it.
Yeah, real good music and voiceovers. Agreed.
And as America says, that is quite true. We appreciate your support for pre-ordering, and that I do. I cannot wait to open the Harvest Moon Collector's Edition. That's on its way here. Again, also on the Switch. That will be an official Emceemur unboxing, and then we will have a live stream of that as well. In fact, I need to make sure that's already shipped.
Yeah.
NIS, could you check on my order status while you're... There is a stuffed animal in it as well, so I gotta make sure that Molly does not get a hold of it before I do. If she checks the mail, the unboxing...
I don't know what happened there.
The unboxing may happen without me. Captain Retro says, physical or download only on the platforms it's on. It is physical on the Switch for sure. It's physical on PS4, I know through what Limited Run was doing, and probably physical now. But sometimes Switch is a little late to the party. You know, their release will come a little later. I don't believe that's the case on this one. Robert Mitchell says, the PS4 version seems to be a bit more expensive. I'll be honest, I haven't looked, but usually it's the other way around.
Usually
Switch
is.
Wants an
it's
extra $10
the Switch tax.
For the cartridge, which is like, you know, in some instances, I don't mind that. If it's a game I desperately want to be on a handheld like that
long-term
and have that option.
It'll last you longer than the disc, so.
This is true. She's just fetching, isn't she? That's not terribly surprising. I find humans have a shockingly weak grasp of time. She talks to her book, and I can't tell you how cool that is. We need more talking books in our D&D campaign. What is this?
What was that? Nier, the original Nier, which not a lot of people played, because Automata kind of put them on the map, but the original Nier had a talking book in it. There also spit lasers.
NIS America says it also has a bit of bonus content that was added, which is good to know.
I believe they also said it had all content from the PS4 and the Vita versions, which I didn't know they had separate.
Yeah. I'm new to the series, I'm not new to the style, so...
Templars, new stages, more branching paths. Sounds like this is the version to have.
Yeah. I guess due to it being a limited run game, maybe, and that very well may be. There's been things I've missed from limited run that I was okay
that
missing, but
you
can't
there's other stuff that you can't get.
Yeah.
If you're on there, you know, the minute that it goes live.
If you change your mind. I kind of wanted a copy of that. What was the Lawbreakers? The Overwatch clone or what? I mean, and that's what it was, but to be fair, it was kind of fun. You overstep your bounds, girl. Do you remember the Dia campaign? You would have been young. Your father nearly died.
Ooh. Okay, so yeah, NIS confirmed that it was originally broken up into two stories, and this is the...
That's what I got from it, yeah.
...version. That's really cool.
The gift I offer you is power. To repair your empire and make it great again, if you wish. Or to simply enrich yourself, if that is what you desire. At your father's behest, I took a central role in your efforts to right this country's wrongs. And you speak with good Maurice here. Maurice Gibb? You'll learn your father found my help invaluable.
Yes, regrettably.
Yes, Captain Retro, the book is talking to her.
Yes!
This is happening.
Leather-bound. Was that going to be a startup?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that really an insult?
And that's the other... That was the other possible player character, wasn't it?
I believe it was, yeah. So you got to wonder how much it will really change the playthrough as you select the other guy. I'm sure he's got his own powers and own things.
Well, if there's branching paths, then...
Yeah.
I dare say that it may make a difference, but even just your play style, I'm sure... It seems like it's a lot of reviving and healing and stuff, and he was probably completely different.
And probably paths on both sides, too, yeah. You know. So, Captain says now he's in, so. See? I knew we'd sell some copies of this game tonight. But, it should sell itself. Because, you know, circling back to what we started with originally was just the look of it when it hits you. And that's all it ever takes for me with these games. I'm just like, I'm done. Oh, anime girl with big eyeballs? Done. Or big other things. Outskirts. Let's see. The Silvery Grove is next. And one cannot mistake the telltale exclamation point. A hedonist aristocrat known for lavish parties.
But a lot of the animated games don't have the full motion. You know, you just
That's
get the static portraits of the characters. The movement in this game is also...
The
Very
book,
cool looking.
The book is one of my favorite characters, says NIS. And you know what? I'm into that, because who knows how much of a character the book ends up being. If this was made into a movie, I wonder who would do the voice acting for the book. Maybe Wanda Sykes, and get a little sass in there.
That's a day one watch, yep.
Oh my god. Arnold. A crude way of putting it, but I suppose they aren't wrong.
Oak City Gamer says they'll be out for a bit, so...
Oak City, always glad
Good
to have
to
you
have
stop
you.
By. Or maybe Stallone. I'm happy to tell you that through me, you could draw upon the power of that realm, you know? I trust you remember your history too well. My father was very insistent. Besides the Harvest Moon thing, we've also got the SNK 40th Anniversary Collector's Edition coming from NIS America this.
Forgot about that.
Oh my gosh. I think you may still be able to get them because, you know, the availability is always really good. I've never had problems getting things from NIS. Comes with some really great
as
stuff.
As long as you look for it before the day of, And you can probably make it happen.
NIS America says, next week we'll have Happy Birthdays on Nintendo Switch.
Which I believe you have an earlier stream of.
We did Birthdays the beginning when it came out on PS4. And we did the Collector's Edition unboxing. It had some fantastic stuff in it. Once again, a little stuffed animal that I had to make sure my daughter did not abscond with. But, man, what a wild game it was. Because, I mean, you start with an amiibo fart. Well, not amiibo. That would cast a completely different shade on it. No. You start with an amoeba fart and build the freaking universe, and next thing you know, you got cavemen wrestling dinosaurs. Not literally the next thing you know. I mean, that takes some development, but everything's such a balance in that game, the ecosystem. You know, if that amoeba fart goes away, there may be something else over here that was smelling it and really needed that, and then it's going to die too. So you got to balance everything, and maybe not so much. There may be things you want out of the food chain. You know, it's your food chain. And you're building stuff around there as you go with it. So it reminded me of Populous a little bit, from a much more larger biology standpoint, because it's not just people, obviously. It's the flora and the fauna.
Oh, now you got this
guy. If you haven't checked out that, Happy Birthdays. And again, another fantastic game, you know, conducive to a great handheld gaming experience, as well as sitting right here in the old game room. Amazing. It's Apollon, the renowned archer. See what he's gonna do to us. We got this big old dude. He looks like something out of Golden Axe.
Yeah.
Each time an exemplar attacks, one node is filled. I like the word node. Don't ask me why. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and wait an hour on that. Computer's trying to update. Any of you all that like Windows 10 don't like it. So Captain Retro says, I have a real POW arcade cabinet, but I'm still going to grab the SNK collection.
Yeah,
and
SNK
I'm still
going to
come play your POW cabinet, but yeah, I'd be lying if I said that's not the game I'm looking forward to most on the SNK collection. Man, POW in the arcade was off the hook, man. It's the $3 cafe now, but it used to be the Western Steer or something like that in Snellville. It was an old steakhouse, and they had the machine there. When we'd go there, my family would eat. They wouldn't see me all at dinner, and I'd be over there fighting. So let's make sure we've got this here, because can't put all the weight on NIS America. I've got to learn to play the game. Each time an exemplar attacks, one node is filled on the combo bar. Choices you make and gemstones can change the combo bar. An exemplar that attacks on a node imbued. I also like the word imbued, I should say.
Good word. Good word.
Good D&D word. By a buff such as haste or focused, will receive it. We are also joined by Orange Juice Jones. Welcome OJJ, and I believe Shadow the Oblivious has joined us. Welcome, guys, to our Tuesday night live stream of Fallen Legion. Rise to glory on the Nintendo Switch. The node enchanted with a blue aura, we've seen that, is a death blow node. And an exemplar that attacks there does a powerful attack. Okay, so we weren't far off from what we thought that was. Be careful, if the combo bar will reset if you get hit or if your combo breaks. So it felt like we had unlimited attacks there for a minute, so that was rolling. When an exemplar has full AP, you can use a powerful technique by pressing ZR and a character at the same time, activating a link attack. This way uses all of an exemplar's AP. You can also trigger a link attack by switching characters to cancel an attack. Okay. Pressing ZL rotates the position. Characters in the middle and rear are covered mode. Okay.
We got some dark dungeon going on here.
Yeah, we do. And
I don't know why I just started to see that comparison, too.
Yeah, not upset about that either.
No, not at all.
Oh my god, not upset about that at all. All right, well, let's do it.
Yeah, this guy was what you were missing. This is what you needed.
Little Sandra's coil action on him there.
Falcon Bay.
And I'm sure I am botching the play all over the place here compared to what I can see being really good at this later on.
Yeah.
And just combining. Okay, now this is it. God, we're so much of this, I almost forgot. You have to actually pick these are the branching paths. Free the drawn trumpet relic. Refuse. Free attack. Oh, I gotta go with free attack. You had me at free attack.
That was cool. I just dug it.
Yeah, man. So
the
it turns
CCG
into
a looking art in the first place.
Now we can take a look at this, but yeah, those are some of the path branching we're talking about here. You get these cards, and then you got to decide what you take. So, between battles, Princess Cecile will make choices that change the fate of Phenumenia. And that's going to play to your builds too. It looks like over time. So you know, that's going to completely change what's already a gameplay experience that has, at a glance, plenty of depth. Each question has three orders you can give. I didn't get to the third one, but I'm feeling good about my pick. Below each order is a tribute you will receive if you pick that order.
Third one was blackmail, but I didn't see its effect.
Yeah, I'm hoping I won't regret my choice, but I like the sound of an extra attack. All exemplars restore HP after you make a decision, and the amount restored depends on your empire's morale. So that's also an interesting balance to throw into it. You can't just be a butthole. You gotta make sure you maintain somewhat of a decent alignment.
Maybe you can, and it has a completely different outcome.
And maybe, yeah. Oh, and Labyrinth of Refrain. That's another one that is definitely gonna be reviewed here day one on the Emceemur Show. Not much NIS isn't reviewed here on the Emceemur Show. It's just, it's what we do. I love all genres of games, I really do, but RPGs, that's it for me. If I can only have one and lose the rest, give me my RPGs.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't intrigued about SNK Heroines Back to Frenzy.
Yeah?
I want to see more. I want to see more. Of
I'm sure HBK will pick that one
up.
You had him at, you had him at Heroines.
Probably have him as a gay.
Yeah,
definitely have him as a heroine.
I think he's already has pre-ordered the 40th. I sent that to y'all the same day, I think, when I saw that. I was like, oh, God.
Yeah.
Get your wallet out. Boop on a bun. Jason Vetrix has joined us. Welcome, Jason. Oh, destroy. Double damage added to the combo bar. Call the restore mana. Fierce added to the combo bar. What do you think? You call this one.
Destroy.
Destroy! And what happens if you don't choose?
You have a time limit, too. That's just... That's the kind of option. Like,
here we go
again.
What
does happen if you don't choose?
Extra death blow added to the combo bar. Receive the Virgone Helm Relic. I wouldn't mind a helm. What do you think?
Yeah, let's go for a helm.
Do I get to wear the helm? Everybody, if you're just joining us, Herbores, anybody just joining us, we are playing Fallen Legion, Rise to Glory on the Nintendo Switch, out today, and if you don't have it, pick it up. And if you missed the first part of the stream, go back and watch the recap. Tell me what you think about this game. Do you like the game? Do you play this game? Do you plan to buy the game? Do you go to the store to buy the game? Do you get to earn money when you bought the game? Do you guys buy it at the store when you bought the game? Do you go to a franchise play? How would you think about this game? Let me know in the comments below what you think about this game. And make sure everybody that is watching this that you like this video. Dropping likes on this video is what helps get it promoted. Throws it out there to make sure that other people are going to know about Fallen Legion on the Switch if they don't already. And if they don't, it's their loss. Because this is fantastic,
this is cool.
Man.
This is really cool.
I can tell you right now that, I mean, despite the backlog, this is getting played. And it's on the Switch, and that's just that much cooler when you have that option. I mean, we got Octopath coming real soon, speaking of RPGs.
Yeah.
Just things like that, man.
Game.
Again, it's just conducive to a great gameplay experience if something like that is available handheld. So. The Slippery Prince has appeared.
I pictured a frog when you said that.
Yeet! I appreciate the consideration. Take this from now. Hope to hear from you soon. What? We collect rare gemstones? Are you kidding me? That's a thing? Anything that there's rares, it could be dog turds.
Yeah.
But the chance that there's a rare one, I'm in.
Very intriguing premise.
Look at all these things. Alright, so that brings the helm into play. Are they hearing from me?
It's an audience we didn't know. It's Paper Mario.
Is your archer on the front line now?
Seems that way. Maybe he shouldn't be. Now, where'd the other guy go? Well, you know, I can only half pay attention to the storyline here between answering questions and trying to figure out if I'm fighting. We'll go back and play this over again, I'm sure, a couple different ways. Six ways from Sunday, from the look of it, so. You violently asserted humankind's dominion over nature without getting your hands dirty. Your father would be proud. Father did have a fondness for violence. I like father already. Look what it says. Crack emerald. So that's where you get the gem. Yeah. Now it's cracked, so I'm assuming that's not like the best or anything, but it's better than a doctor.
It is slightly better than a doctor.
Slightly better. Religion in Phenumia is not particular. Oh. Okay. You found a gemstone. Press X to open the menu and choose the gemstone. Applause. Yeah, I like that. The sound is great in this. Yeah. Man. And that makes it too. That makes it do. Because imagine playing this thing with a headset on, just kind of chilled out in the corner.
It's quality across the board from what I can tell.
It is, and that just adds to the level of immersiveness. And what's funny is sometimes RPGs need that sound and all that the least. It's not like it's Call of Duty, but when you have it, I don't know, it's just, it's gravy on an otherwise already delicious dish.
I mean, yeah. Just...
So let's do what it says. Let's go to the gemstones. And we're going to equip a cracked emerald.
Venegas has to head out.
Venegas, too. Mr. V, the man on the West Coast toy scene. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. V. Always great to have you on TNL. All right, so we've got that. Make sure it took. Yep. Save data. I know it auto-saves, but when we
I'm
an old man, dude. Yeah, I just feel better saying, okay, it's saved. Okay, thank you. You know, I feel better knowing that way.
If you have the choice, you got to keep 45 different save slots.
You sure do. You sure do. Although, I won't do that on my first playthrough. I won't allow it. But eventually, if you want to satisfy knowing the totality of this whole thing, that's probably going to be necessary. Herbore says, I love Disgaea 5. I can't wait to bust into Disgaea 5.
I haven't played 5.
I've got it on PS4, and it's another one of those I haven't got to yet.
4 or 5, but man, are those good games.
And it's a huge commitment.
Because
of the size, you know? And I'm down. It's right there. Can't wait to do it. But, you know, we're talking at least 200 plus hours of your life gone. And that's fine. I don't want to even give the image that I don't like long games. But yeah, dude, it's like, okay, you can have one game. All right, Disgaea. The collector's edition for the remaster, the first one looked fantastic.
It was a great game.
Yeah. And, you know, I missed out on so many of
those. I haven't played 4 and 5, and I'm still probably going to replay one before I...
Well, you know, I didn't have a PS3 years back, and because of that, there was a lot of NIS titles that I didn't get to jam on right away that I'm still having to catch up on.
I had the original, but I was on the ball, and I don't think I played Disgaea until maybe PSP or... Even they did it on DS.
Yeah, that's true.
The original DS had the first Disgaea.
NIS says, well, I'll let that slide for now. But, I'm racking them up here. So, you know what? I love tactics games where you're talking about a bunch of squares and moving units around. I don't care what it is. If I see squares, sold. Done. It's Final Fantasy Tactics, man. I got hooked on that style of game and never could kick the habit.
Well, even, like, Tactics Ogre go all the way back. Well, yeah. Probably not even all the way back, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, just always dug the 2.5D grid-based combat.
right, Maurice. We're in desperate need of an emperor, and Phenumia needs that to be you. Fine. I'm an emperor. For now. Or an empress, as it were.
Oh, this is our other exemplar. The girl with the spear. For the lance.
You received a Virgon helm. This rusted helmet comes from a kingdom ravaged by a powerful storm. The soul inside this helm can protect your exemplars from harm. Good to know. Oh, we got the whole gang going here.
Can you play them all at once?
It's feeling nice. That way, yeah.
There we go.
So we're invulnerable for 15 seconds. Press R to use it. Relics break at the end of the level or after you use them. But these enchanted items can turn the tide of battle. So it's like I don't really want to use it, you know? Not yet, anyway.
No.
Not against these two turds. It was the trigger. Yeah, there. That's moving them around.
There we go. Yeah, I think the archer might need to be second to land. There, that's it right there.
Good shot.
They seem to move around on their own accord.
And maybe that's part of it. Maybe you gotta keep their butts in line. Penalty? Legal formation? This dude's taking it like a champ. He thinks he's heading for the hills. Crit happens. Oh no, this guy looks like there's a chance that he might mean business. Phalanx.
That shield.
Yeah.
My God.
Targe of the Blooded.
Though he managed to leap his bicep.
He did. That's his hole in the Death Star there. He's got that bicep sticking. And his traps look like they're available to be sliced. Although he's talking, so he may not have beef. He either lit a fart or we're about to have a fight. You do realize books are flammable. Desperation. She enters a trance if all her exemplars fall in battle. Mashing. That's a great word, isn't it? Mashing X restores mana during this desperate state. With a little finesse, you can charge enough mana to fire an attack spell or summon a fallen exemplar. So, okay.
I will not let Phenumia fall!
What happened to my exemplars? Forgive me. I find it difficult to bind souls to this world. Duke District is complaining of a ballooning homeless population. We don't want to displace them, don't we?
Yeah.
They make for some awkward situations at the red lights.
Well, the defense bonus never hurt anybody either.
Yeah, I don't have any money. Yeah. You better have your ducks in a row for that and really understand.
Our knight's about half damage. Remember how to heal on that?
I believe we have to hit up.
Yeah. Might have been down an X, up an X.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I see it there now. Hard to tell when she's ready to go on, though.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta hold it on there. I'm seeing it now. Move it with the D-pad, hold it in place.
Ah.
put him on the map.
So NIS says no date on Disguise on this for
Alright, so we lost the knight, and we need to put him back out there. And there he is. I guess in some cases it may be okay just to let them get ripped and come right back out. Unless there's a real con and not a pro. This poor lizard ain't live in concert. So she is healing, just not a whole lot.
I'm sure that increases.
There's probably opportunities to make that increase, like don't displace your health with people or something like that. Make the Duke a cake. Various choices you can make that might result in the desired outcome.
It's hard to be a lizard.
I'm telling you, it's not a lizard's world. Unless you work for Geico. A spy has been caught trying to infiltrate your inner sanctum. Ooh. Execute just sounds good, but at the same time. And the relics are cool. What do I do? We want a relic. We're gonna experiment on them? Is that what we're gonna do? Is that how I picked it? Like, we're gonna cut them open?
Oh, whoa.
Look at the tree.
That's cool.
You the tree ant, dude. Yeet the tree. Yeet. The Sky Splitter. I thought it'd be a kind of short song. Hey. Well, they have the spine splitter.
Yep. They
could. Yeah, East 8, that's one that I have not got to.
I've never played an East game.
Really?
Believe it or not.
I think I've beat East 3 three or four times on both Genesis and Super Nintendo.
I don't know how I've managed to miss them.
Well, at one point, you know, there was one on Master System, and they were on the Turbo Duo, but, you know, that's not something your buddy has when you go to his house necessarily.
Well, they've re-released the first ones like a dozen times.
Yeah.
I have no excuse.
True. Asa. Got a crack ruby.
You don't seem to be doing terrible according to the grades.
Yeah, it feels like that it's going to let me know real soon that I'm not as good as I might think I am at the moment. Not that I even think I'm that good. Longinus shifts to gladiator stance. I'm guessing maybe these stones apply to different ones of the party or whatever.
Yeah,
June 26th is our East 8 Switch release date. Well, let's check that out. Okay, so Fierce added to the combo bar. That apparently wasn't there before, so now we add that. And we have
with the stance, I haven't seen a lot of...
Or what that does, what that does. It's going to be interesting
to see.
Several
references to it, but...
It looks as if we have received a donation from the good Mr. CM Retro. Nice. CM, I didn't even... We kind of have the part covered up there where that would have come up on screen, though, so I just now got the notification. But see him if you're still here. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts right here at the Emceemur Show. And you know that every last dime that you put toward the Emceemur Show is going to be spent on bringing you only the greatest quality content each and every time. And if it doesn't, you know where I live. Okay. It's nice to be able to reconnect Nintendo fans with the series.
Yeah,
I'm
absolutely.
Saying, yeah. And I have not, since I haven't gotten to East 8 yet, I was playing East Origins already on PS4, but I think I would like to try East 8 on the Switch. If
just
I have
as
my
an
pick.
RPG fan, just being able to see RPGs coming back to Nintendo proper is just fantastic. Not that the 3DS didn't. This
right.
DS, 3DS, great RPG catalogs. But their main home consoles have been a little while without that being a focus.
Is it interesting?
Definitely wrapping back around to that. What's that now?
That dude has like the least strength, but he's a big old dude.
Was he a tank?
Apparently. Health.
Yeah, health and defense. Yeah, makes sense. He's there to take the hits. If you gave him strength on top, he might be a little bit too much. Who has the strength? The Lance Girl?
Yes. Lance Girl.
I'm okay with that. I have a thing for Lance Girls.
Yes. I have heard. Unc, thanks so much for stopping by. Uncle Strange heading out. Thanks for being here, buddy. Always great to have you in the stream. We've got, you know, we've only got enough slots for the people we've got. I imagine you're going to get others later on. You're going to be forced to make some difficult decisions as far as that goes. So,
Roaming Dan's correct. We do need a new pretty game, dude.
Yeah? Gaston has a stranglehold on the Pelican Fortress, a critical military outpost. But his insatiable appetite to expand his demesne has ruffled feathers with other princes. That's a word of the day. That reminds me of something. What is it reminds me of? The music.
Yeah, it's cool though. Again, great soundtrack.
Lizards are not necessarily having what they want, but they're tearing holes right up. And for a guy on defense, he's taking some licks. NIS America, as soon as I get promoted to CEO, I'll be sure to document my journey in game form.
That's the dream.
Receive the golden watch relic? I think Zulfikar needs a new stance, so we're going to give him one, just in case. Princess Gracia's allies have introduced legislation that would damage Prince Gaston's operations. What do we do? There's a pro and a con to each, except that first one.
Yeah. So, death blows do extra damage, sounds.
Yeah. Alright, so we're going with that.
Fairly safe.
Won't be one you get to use as much, but there
that's
is.
An interesting
the, that's
thing
the
too.
Balance.
Time,
where...
I bet you have to start there. Keep that in mind. A lot of them are going to have pros and cons.
And the con of something being no, you know, downside to picking it is that it's probably going to be something you don't get to use there at all, albeit something good.
Yeah.
Death blows obviously don't come up there in 5 seconds. Crystalis sequel, breaking news. You heard it here first. Never played all the way through Crystalis, though, and I'll be happy to also do that on the Switch for the 40th anniversary. The Kari Warriors on there, too, for where that's concerned.
Yep.
So, you know, an arcade version of these games were really good. You can kind of one-hand this game if you want to. Always kind of do that on RPGs. If I can have coffee and play, fantastic, you know. Record rains have overloaded the capital's ancient sewer system.
Critical hit chance. Up 10% seems like a lot, so...
I'm gonna go with that.
Yeah.
We can get another Burgon Helm relic, because if you use it, it's gone. But we still have the one that I didn't waste it yet, so... Alright, now we got some tough cusses here. Oh no, it's gone because it was the end of the round. I think you only get it for that round. Because I didn't use it, so I had to lose it. I'm digging this so far. NIS America must be going now. Thank you all for being here to watch the gameplay. Thank you, NIS America, for being the best part of the Emceemur Show. Coming out today to get with us and do the Q&A session for the launch of this fantastic game. And keep the hits coming. And check on my Harvest Moon order if you get a minute. Can't wait to get that in the mail. Again, thanks so much for being here. Absolutely fantastic. And yes, I hope that everybody watching here tonight is going to rush right out and pick up a copy of Fallen Legion and get down to business on this. I bet you'll beat it before I do. Prince Michael's Emissary. You can now acquire the Indrayani Cloak during battles.
Yeah, Robert Mitchell Winston's the love they put into their collector's
edition. I'm telling you.
Second to none.
I mean, you've already got a great game, but you know the company thinks as much of it as you do when you've got great extras coming, not only physically, but digitally, too. These great collections, you know, all-inclusive DLCs in one set. And I can't take it sometimes. I look at some of these RPGs today, and, you know, I think about what would I have done back in the 90s, you know, if we had stuff like this. You know, obviously a lot of these games take a page out of classic RPGs, and then in some cases they completely reinvent the way we ever thought about them working, and now are able to have this depth that maybe before they weren't, so. And we got a cracked Sapphire, so there's that. But, yeah, quality is through the dadgum roof. Through the roof. But that's NIS America. NIS games, that's how it works. So this, you know, we're about out of time for tonight's live stream. But I think we've got a great first look at this.
Absolutely. I'm won over.
This is
happening.
Yeah, I'm impressed with what I've seen here. And it's going to continue to get played. It's staying in the Switch, at least until I can't take it anymore. And I don't know if that will ever be, because again, we have so many different ways this can be done, just in what we've seen here tonight, as far as the past, the branch, the options that you had for power-ups, the decisions that you made on the political, you know, questions that they threw at you. And again, like you said, love that it's in a CCG format. That just makes the heart happy. Yeah. Chances for rare gems. We're collecting gems on the side, too. Rarity. Hey, this was a fantastic episode of Tuesday Night Live Stream. I want to thank again NIS America for being a part of this stream. I want to thank you, my co-host Triple J J-Town,
always
James Jones,
to be here,
resident RPG expert. Great to have you on the show. And I want to thank each and every one of you that came by, that rolled through TNL tonight. And again, if you're still watching out there, or if you're on here later watching the recap, I hope that you're going to like this video. And if you have not already done so, I hope you're going to go out there and get you a copy of Fallen Legion for the Nintendo Switch. And also, if you have not already done so, it is my extreme hope that you're going to subscribe if you like watching people play RPGs day one when they come out and unbox their ridiculously large collector's editions where applicable, something we do a lot of right here on the Emceemur Show. Can't ask for more than that. Guys, thanks again for stopping by. Emceemur, Triple J, signing out for now, and I'll see each and every one of you again next time.